How long do we want to wait here? Call ally. Greek liberation against Albania. Albania is allied with the fucking Russians. Yeah. No. Never, Greece. Bye, Greece. You're dead. Russians are gonna kill you. Lose militancy? Sounds good. So what are we going to next? Because I guess that'll determine how long we wait for this. Where we are right now, we could take like one colony, and we wouldn't even be able to take one state if we wanted to take a state. Also Johnny Guitar, nice. So I think we still need lower infamy before we go into a big war, because I don't want, like, one colonial thing, that's the best we'd get, probably, and that's not great. Host the Olympic Games? Yes. You know, it's... Oh, also, did we upgrade our railroads, didn't we? Maybe not. Maybe they've already been upgraded everywhere by capitalists. I mean, there are a lot of them being built, so that's possible. Belgium? Sure. What are our taxes looking like? Yeah, see, like, I could lower a lot of these, I think. But we can't, some of them, I just can't lower it anymore.
Just let your infamy go down so you can enact your Frankreich plan.
Yeah, I think that's the thing to do. I think the thing is, I think we just need to get our infamy down as much as we can and then destroy, France. And that'll be pretty good. Oh. Lower taxes too much. Organize Namibia. Sure. More research. Prestige gain is obviously quite good. We need to invent German jazz before any other country invents jazz. Actually, is there German jazz? Does Germany have like a jazz scene? Oh, look at that! Hey! Ireland has been spit out as a satellite. Don't know why. Don't know why they even bother. But it happened. And they're owned by... They're ruled by socialists. What do you know? What about UK? Also socialist. Well, I guess that's what it is. Yep. We have one extra guy here, so we will encourage craftsmen here. Yeah. Yep. Bernard, okay, whatever. It might be interesting to look here how many, we're encouraging craftsmen, how many craftsmen we have in each of these places. Like, some of these are really low. Like, that's only 10%. A lot of laborers, though. 10%. 25%. See, I don't need to worry about this one too much more. 20 almost. 16, 14. Those first couple actually kind of need it. 3. Yeah, give me one of those. Give me one of these lower ones. Actually, that one. Because that one's fine. 10. No, it's not. What about these other ones that I'm working on right now? I guess would be the question. 14, 14. 15. Yeah, take it out of the Rhineland and put it here. Yeah. Okay. Just trying to get the most bang for my buck with those. Romania again? I don't think so. Netherlands? I am fine with. On the other hand. Wonder what Japan's up to. They're still our ally, right? Nothing weird happened there. Please click them. Yeah. Still an ally. One faith. Let's take another drink. Gotta get to bed. Great stream as always, leaving it running in the background. Oh, thanks, I guess. See ya. Night. I keep considering maybe starting streaming a little earlier in the day. I think it seems like it'd be a lot more convenient for a lot of people, but I just never do it. I don't know. Conservative and reactionary parties. Okay, so nothing changed. I don't know how they keep winning. They have 32% of the vote. The socialists by themselves have 37, and yet this coalition always wins. I don't get it, but if I guess it's democracy working, is what it is. Nazi Israel, the swastika shall soar over the city of David. It should. I hope we. The problem is, if we go to war with France, that's going to be our big thing, right? We're building up to a big thing happening right now. It could be a war with the Ottomans. Oh, Italy, who is allied with the Ottomans? They must have just got that through an event. That kind of sucks. I'd kind of rather go to war with the Ottomans than Italy. They are allied, so I guess it'd be kind of one and the same. I guess it doesn't matter much, really. I guess actually Italy is kind of... No, I would rather do the Ottomans because I'd want to take Israel. And we'd take Palestine or whatever you want to call it. Jerusalem. And I would have... Yeah, if I went to war with the Ottomans, it would have been take this and take this. And then that's it. But now that's not an option. Which kind of blows. We'll ally Greece, even though they'll probably just try and call us into some stupid war. Yeah, I mean, Italy's not a terrible choice, but the thing is, they don't have a lot of colonies. You know, all their stuff is actually theirs, other than this. We could take this. But the Ottomans, like, all of this stuff is colonies. Just all of this. So it's very cheap to take. We could take big swaths of Ottoman land to have fucking German Middle East. And, it'd be cheap. It's a lot cheaper than taking bits of Italy. Nationalist China's kicking ass. Let's take a look. You're right. And they're starting to get stronger. Sichuan's still better, but they're not taking advantage of that. I think Sichuan's gonna die pretty soon. Because they won't... They could kill Nationalist China right now. But they won't do it. I wish these guys weren't civilized. I think that might be... I don't think they're even supposed to be civilized. I think that's just the game. I think that might be one of this mod's ways of preventing you from going too heavy into China. Because that is just a cheap way of doing this. You know, it's just guaranteed to catapult you. We just invented fascism, by the way. I think. Yeah, we invented the doctrine of fascism, which gives fascist rebels a higher thing. I don't think it actually invents fascists. What does invent fascists? Like, how do we not have fascists already? Should be under this, probably, right? Maybe it's one of these? I have no idea. If anyone knows what invents fascism,
pretty sure fascism activates at 1905.
Okay. Oh, I just realized. I think I might have been missing something. Yeah, I'm missing these possible inventions right here, which do give you some stuff. No, never mind. That's for something else. Never mind. I don't know. Those are just in general. These are the investments. Yeah, okay, I was looking at the right thing. All right, 1905, that works. We'll see then. I've fallen asleep and missed two streams because it starts at 10 for me. So you're saying you would be in favor of an earlier stream? It's not impossible. It might be... I would just kind of have to shift my whole schedule by an hour, but that's not out of the question. I've been kind of considering it and just starting it at, like, 6. You know, and just making it... I don't think any... Like, I don't... I guess the question is that bad for anyone? Would anyone be upset if it was an hour earlier? Like, I don't know, someone in Europe somewhere or something where this is convenient? I don't know. More consciousness, great. Our infamy is getting there, but it's still... This is one complaint with these kind of games, and it's just the fact that you always have waiting periods. And there's not usually a lot to do, and it's not just Victoria 2, it's like every single Paradox game, you just have periods where people are too upset with you, and you gotta cool down. And the game doesn't give a good reason to... It doesn't really give you anything to do during that. I mean, this one at least has, you know, tons of pop-ups, but they're pop-ups that you've seen millions of times. So you just sort of click through them automatically. You don't sit there and think like, oh, what am I going to do about this? It's like, oh, tensions dissipate. Ooh, this one's not even a choice. It's just, oh, I lose militancy. Good. Demonstration turns sour. More reactionary. That sounds good. But they get more militant. Oh, whatever. Nobel Prize in Literature. Good. See, I mean, that's all good. It's just like, it's not going to take up time or anything. Let's make the army better. Let's invent gas attacks. I guess, okay. Wait a minute. I think the wait is over. Once we get gas attacks, we're going to go to war. Yeah. No, that is for sure. We have to go to war immediately once we get gas.
Industry is double digits.
By double digits, do you mean quadruple digits? But yeah. Double digits is not very impressive.
Quadruple digits.
Hearts of Iron 4, or Hearts of Iron in general, is the only one that doesn't have a weird coalition thing. Well, that's a reason to play one of those then. But I think I'd almost rather play 3. But 3 is like an autistic game. As if these aren't. But, you know what I mean. It's pretty involved with the army management and stuff. But that's what is what makes it better than Hearts of Iron 4, where they just kind of did away with a lot of that, it seems. Let's go 7. This is something to keep us busy, I guess. The problem being that... I guess I can unpause while I do this. Yeah, that's one grouping. Sure. Put those down by the Italians. And then we don't actually have enough artillery for, like, anything else. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send these guys down here. You move over here. And then... that's just more infantry. We're going to bring all these down, and we're going to see if we can't... We're going to bring some of these over, because I'm pretty sure we have, like, thousands of artillery just sitting around here. No, that's a real unit. But yeah, that's just artillery. And actually, we might just bring some artillery back. I kind of like that. Let's take a look at all this. That's infantry. That's infantry and such. Infantry. Yeah. So actually, where are our boats? Where's the boats? Probably at the top, aren't they? The north end. North end. Yeah. Wait. Oh. Yeah. These two boats go here. Come together. And then we'll... and that's two more battleships, by the way. Yeah, we'll come and pick these guys up. Bring them over. Albania I can do something with. I don't really care about Albania. Cool, great, I'm neutral, great. How is Portugal coming along? Banned again, which means we should start focusing on something else with our points so that we're not wasting them. What is not taken? Romania, no thanks. Greece is something. Greece is something. Nationalist China might, I don't know about that. They're a little big. The big ones take a really long time to do. Nationalist China wants an alliance. That sounds great, actually. I don't really know who else. Madagascar we already have. Transvaal? I guess Transvaal and Orange make a lot of sense. They've got decent population. We ally them already. Might as well get something out of it. Not like they're going to be useful allies, so... Yeah, really, at this point, it's just we need to invent gas attacks, and then it's World War One time. Let's up our taxes a tiny bit. Let's up our taxes more. We're making good money. We'll keep it there. At 100%. Transvaal is already increasing opinion. Probably they're... Oh, wow. They already liked us quite a bit. Probably because we keep defending them and such, and standing up for the little guy. I am very happy that our industrial power is finally over 1,000. I'm not so happy since people brought to my attention that's a little behind schedule. But fine. I have to get in the habit of doing some of this stuff just while the game is unpaused so that we can roll through the time at moments like these. It just seems so inefficient, right? Like, these things need to be upgraded. If I paused and upgraded them, they'd be upgraded that much sooner, right? I'm wasting time. This little in-between time where I'm sitting and clicking through them. Time's ticking. Colonial unrest. That sucks. But, like, it's not efficient with my time. In-game time, it's more efficient, but not me. And that's what matters. And your time, right? Don't want to waste your time. So, I'm just going to do it like this. Oh, look, it's done. Okay, now we just need to get the invention, which is gas attack, which we have a 4% chance of every month. So, very likely that we will be getting gas attack soon, which means, I mean, that means we're getting, what was I gonna say? War? Oh yeah, that means we're going to war soon, so I'm definitely gonna go more army tech. And our infamy is falling pretty heavily, pretty quick. Sabotage. Less socialist. That sounds good. Our athletes won the Olympics again. More prestige. Our prestige is unmatched. I would just like to point this out real quick. The difference between our prestige and the Russians, who are number two. The Russians... What? Really? Wow! The Russians, who are number two in prestige, have 288. We have almost 2,000. Our prestige is incredible. Our industry is not great, the more I look at it. But just ignore that. Don't call attention to it. Don't even think about it. But our prestige is very good, which is my excuse, you know. We're focusing on being prestigious. In fact, we might want to fabricate something pretty quick here and get ready. We might want to get our lines ready. I think we are going to war with France. France has no allies, which is what we like to see. They do have a decent military, but by decent, I mean a third of ours alone, right? You have to also keep in mind the fact that we will not be alone. Japan will join, probably. Brazil might join. The Netherlands will probably join. Belgium will probably join. And, of course, Denmark always joins. They're pretty nice, you know? They're an okay little country. Transvaal again. Okay. Probably means we can add them. Yep. That was quick. Let's add the other guy, too. Orange. Why not? Okay. So. We should decide what we want from France. If we justify. In fact, let me unpause while I do this. Yeah, perfect. I can dismantle them. Dismantling costs 20, so I can't do that, actually. Isn't dismantling free if it's like a great war? I think it is. Although, is dismantling really good? Someone please explain to me what dismantling does again, because don't you get some stuff if you dismantle them? We could also liberate a country like, it would probably be Brittany. We could also place in the sun a couple of things. Take a state. If we took a state, I think it would be just right on the border here. We would just take, like, this. Whatever this is. Lorraine. Yeah, that's probably rightfully German. That's actually a little smaller than I thought it was. But yeah, just a nice little thing like that. Or the colonies, I don't know.
I think dismantling means all their colonies are stripped of them and their military is limited for X amount of time.
Alright, but the colonies... Someone mentioned that you might get the colonies. Is that true? Like, if I... Ooh, look, Australia's free. Quote, unquote, free. Still underneath the Queen, but they've got their own flag now, so... You know, free. Freer than New Zealand, but again, that doesn't mean much. They're also owned by socialists, just like the rest of the UK. So there's that as well. But yeah, like, do we have a chance to get their colonies? Because in that case, that's a really good one. Because we could get this, we could get that. Like, isn't it... Someone said something about it being split up among the people who win the war. Which would mean that would be great. I would love that. Orange. Yeah, Greece opinion. And stop with Transvaal. Are there any other little guys? We should take over footage alone. Yeah, we should take over footage alone. That's what we're going to do real quick. We're going to unsphere them. Just, we need something to do, right? We're going to remove footage alone from the sphere. And then we're going to take them over. And it'll be free, so we don't need to worry about it. It will make temporarily, our infamy will go down slower, but it'll be
the colonies are split up between the great powers in the war. Might be all the great powers, but not totally certain on that.
Oh, so you're saying it might be that, that all great powers get a piece. Not just me and Japan, maybe, but, like, France would also get... Or, well, not France. I'm going to war with France. But, like, the UK might get a piece or something. If you could look that up, that'd be great. Because there's a big difference there. You know? But, interesting. No, I don't need Place in the Sun. I need the Scramble, which is free. Call? No. Would Japan join? They wouldn't even. Yeah, no. Yeah, we have 919. They have 0. I don't think this is going to be a big problem. Someone might join in. That's possible. If they do, I think we can basically beat whoever it is. I mean, we beat the UK. There's not really anyone else who could compete with us. I mean, the US could join, but I don't know what they would even do. Like, we could just block all their ports. Just like not let their boats through. I wonder how good their navy is, actually. Their navy is way better than the UK's was. I wonder how good they are now, by the way. The UK's navy still does not exist. I don't understand why they haven't built it up all this time. They really should. They're kind of missing out there. Yeah, let's get this little quick little war out of the way. They've already... Oh, wow, okay. I said quick, but... What? I made a mistake. Yep. Yeah, I made a mistake.
Forces a country to give independence to everyone in territory back to everyone else. Basically relinquish all its territories that have other nations' cores as well. For example... Usually, France gets cut in half by releasing Occitania in the south. Russia ends up similar to modern Russia.
UK loses India, might lose Ireland as well, etc. It doesn't always have the same end result. It also transfers all of its colonies to nations on the winning side. Okay, that makes me think it's very worthwhile to go to war with France for dismantling them and taking all of their colonies. We accidentally peaced out for, like, nothing, but for some reason we don't have a truce. We do have a truce, but it still lets us declare war. Why is that? Why can I still declare war? I'm gonna save real quick. I'm not really sure what that's about, but I'm gonna save real quick. And make sure this isn't some sort of mistake on the game's part, but it sure looks like... Sure looks like I can declare war here and nobody cares... Oh, not that one. Scramble for Africa. No infamy or anything. I proceed. And there's no problem. I have a truce with them, but I'm still able to go to war with them again. Don't really see the point of a truce then, but not gonna complain. I did mess up, and I'm happy that I have this chance to redeem myself here and get what I wanted, all of the stuff I wanted. But it is a little strange that I was able to declare that war. I shouldn't be able to. The UN should intervene here. I know the UN doesn't exist, but you'd think somebody'd be a little upset. I don't know. I'm breaking truces. Just goes against everything. If you dismantle UK, you can get 95% of India sometimes. Okay, well now you've just made an interesting point. Which is that we don't have to go to war with France. We go to war with the UK. who we did just win against recently. But you know what? I think we take it one step at a time. We've still got, like, what, 30 years left in the game? I think it's very possible we could do both. Dismantle France and then after that the UK. France is, after all, our big rival. They always have been. And they've made their way. They've scrambled back up to great power status, which means we need to put them in their fucking place. I also do like Occitania popping out. Would be pretty interesting. But I don't know. The UK does have a lot that we would be interested in. I would very much enjoy this. And this. And this. And you know. Just in general, that sounds pretty good. This. Some of the stuff here. This here. Newfoundland. That's all pretty good. I also like how Canada took this. It probably happened a long time ago, but it's just kind of interesting. This song is super, super quiet, by the way. I'm going to skip it. Afro-Jewish jazz. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. That might be an option, too. Either way, we have to wait for this to drop down, but we could try and take everything from the UK. It would definitely be harder. Let's take orange. Cool. But it's an option. Who do we want to take next? Or who do we want to sphere? Liberia? No. Any South Americans available? Brazil. Yeah. Portugal is still number one, but we keep getting kicked out. I don't think that's ever going to happen. Which is unfortunate. Whoa, that's really weird. Spain is underneath the sphere of Switzerland, as is Hungary. That just sounds like nonsense to me. That sentence sounds nonsensical. Annex footage alone. Thank you. Look at that. Very nice. A lot smoother. Free People against Netherlands by Belgium. Oh, neat. Alliance Madagascar. Pretty sure we already had that. Alliance from Sichuan. I don't know about that one anymore. We are still sphering you, so I guess it's fine, but you're not actually stronger than Nationalist China anymore, so if they declare war on you, I'm just gonna duck out of that one. Wage slavery. More liberal, huh? Well, that'll counteract the socialist a bit. Oh my, okay. Alright, that's not great. Orange Alliance sounds good. That's fine. I still want a Spanish Alliance, but I guess, yeah, they're underneath Switzerland, so I can't do that. How is Switzerland still in this? I mean, just barely. Who's number 9? This is interesting. Sweden. With 4. Yeah, Sweden could actually overtake them. And they've got a sizable army. Bigger than Switzerland. The Netherlands would also be an actual reasonable choice to be there. Like, Sweden has only 1.25 million. It's actually kind of impressive that they can even be that high on the ranking with that little. But the rankings kind of fall off pretty quick after the first couple. Boiler explodes. I don't care. Just keep it going. Leaflet campaign. I don't care. Just keep it going. Gas. Really? We still haven't invented gas attacks, but we just invented gas defense, which sucks because that means whoever we go to war with might have gas defense now because it's been long enough that it's possible the U.S. wants an alliance. Are we still allied with Japan? No. The U.S. wants an alliance. Now, the U.S. is like the second strongest army in the world, we being number one. An alliance between us seems like, yeah. I mean, you might say, Michael, they're overseas. They're not going to help for dick, but we had the same problem with the Japanese. They helped okay. You know, if we're worrying about that, we don't want Japan. And who else is there? Russia? They hate us. Not that badly, but they do hate us. Italy's okay. The UK hates us for sure. And that's it. That's like all the great powers that are worth mentioning. So actually, U.S.-German alliance is pretty good.
Germano-American alliance. The beasts of their respective continents.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, yeah, it's the king of Europe. And the king of the Americas. East and West coming together here. Although it is kind of strange to call Germany East. But I guess either side of the Atlantic. Or the Pacific. We both have Pacific holdings. All right. Invent gas attack, please. Some people died. Choose a trade policy. I might actually change my mind on one of these. Yeah, we can upgrade our minimum tariff. I don't want that, actually. Let's set some flexibility so I can actually lower it if I want to. Because I think I might. Yeah, we're making a lot of money. I think we can lower it a little. No, don't lower it that much. Just a little. Just lower it a little. That way it should make it make the capitalists a little more... A little more profitable. They do a little bit more. Bolt action rifle sounds good. I don't think there's anything else we really need right away. Nope. Some things that'd be nice, but... Ooh, let's bump that up one more. It really didn't get to look... Oh, there it is! Gas attack! Okay. But, if we want to do dismantle, that'll cost 20. And now it's completely possible... that we don't get caught, and it'll be fine. But that means we'd have to get through half of it before getting caught. And that's pretty risky. I don't think that's a good idea. But it does come down to the fact, are we willing to risk it, considering that it would be the United States and Germany against everyone? Although, I do have a question. A very important one. Netherlands wants alliance too. Cool. If we get into a war because of having too high infamy, will my allies still honor that? Or do they get like a way out because we're too bad to have allies or something stupid like that? That's important. Is this German rap? Add Brazil to sphere. Well, that was fast. Okay, next. Probably Bolivia, I think, was available. No? Paraguay? Venezuela? Yeah, Venezuela, I guess. No allies dishonor the alliance. That's what I thought.
You might not get the full 20, but you will probably still get over the limit. I don't think your allies help in infamy wars.
Yeah, well, in that case, there's no way we can do this. I mean, it's a waiting game. Unfortunately, it's devolved into that. I'm keeping an eye out for things that we might be able to take without doing that kind of thing, but really there's nothing left. I mean, everything is civilized. All of Africa seems to have been taken, except these little bits that are owned by the UK, basically. Okay, people are dying. Yep. And the problem is it's getting late. I might have to call it soon. But I want to fucking gas some people before we stop, right? Like, but it's just stupid to try and do this. Well, let's do the math. What is this? Put down the revolt. This is actually somewhat important. Also, what was I gonna say? There was something I was gonna ask to the experts in chat. But I don't remember what it was. I'm gonna keep the game going while I'm thinking of that. Oh! Yeah, our Great War is invented. How do I check that? I think they are. I think the fact that we can do dismantling means that it's a Great War. So what I was gonna say, isn't dismantling free if you're in a Great War? Could we maybe finagle this to start a Great War so then we could dismantle them for free? Because, yeah, if you look at dismantle, have invented mass politics. I think that's the one that's a Great War, but I don't know. Call ally against who? Against Basotho? DeSoto? That's a UK. I'm sorry about that. No. I wish you the best of luck, but if the UK joins, I don't really want to deal with that. Yeah, because that's an option. If we can just turn this into a great war, which I think, doesn't there have to, there has to be like two great powers on each side, or two great powers on one side and one on the other? Great wars are supposed to be invented in 1890. Okay, so then almost certainly we have great wars available. Am I right, though, about great wars giving you that for, like, for free? War against Gabu. Are you stupid? Gabu's owned by the UK. Why do these guys think they can just fucking attack the UK and they're not going to care? I mean, they might be right. It looks like they're right here. And they might be right in the Netherlands case, too, but it's a little risky, my man. Venezuela. Friendly, okay. Two on each side. Okay, so could we do that? Germany and America on one side, but I don't think France has anyone. Yeah, France doesn't have anyone. If France allied the UK, it would actually be pretty nice. State of emergency. Why? I'm not even at war. Why would I do that? Does lower war exhaustion. How's that looking? Zero. Why would I do that?
Great wars have great war capitulation, which to my knowledge either isn't as overpowered or is just something different.
Oh, maybe that's what I was thinking. I thought great wars were like the same, though. Do a crisis. How do I do a crisis? Ooh, there are little flashpoint things. Wait a minute. Maybe I can flashpoint something. Let me try and flashpoint France. Let me look. There's a map for that. This could work. Okay, here's a flashpoint. Encouraging flashpoint tension requires revolution and counter-revolution. Do I have that? Yeah, I've had it for a while. So what, is this not potential? It's not high enough? Well, it is a potential, right? Oh, unless this is a potential flashpoint for your cores. Oh, never mind. So yeah, I can't do that. So it's not like I can actually force there to be a flashpoint thing. Limburgian. Wait, Belgium, my ally, wants me to join against Netherlands, my ally. No, you can fuck off. Now neither of them are my ally. Netherlands will probably accept, though. Yeah, and they're going to win. On the wiki, it just says Great War Capitulation is the same as cut down to size, which just disarms them. Oh, yeah, that's bad. That's pretty bad. I don't want that. We might actually have to wait. Oh, alliance from U.S. Wait. Yeah, I mean, that was the plan. I thought we already had that. We might actually have to wait all the way until it gets to, like, 5. Which is just... I mean, if you were playing this game by yourself, there's an easy thing to do here. And that's that you would just save scum. You would just... also, I don't know why. I don't want that alliance. You would just... save. Try it. If you get caught, load. And if you don't get caught, then you're good. I don't want to do that. That seems pretty shitty. But, I don't know. It would be faster. Let's get better army. Yeah. We're out of music again. I got back up for a little bit. Yeah. Sounds like it's skipping. That's just how the sound songs, just so you know. Labor unions. Kill them. It's an album I found recently. I kind of like this. It's pretty all right. I've been listening to it. I got it on a CD for the car. Because that's what I've got to do. Oh, it's a little loud, though. Wait a minute. Oh, also, someone added something. So, hope you didn't like that. Because it's gone. Venezuela. Although Doom is a fucking great alternative. Hey, Portugal again. Please, Portugal, please let me kick you out of the UK sphere. That's not going to happen.
We'll try.
Evolution of Doom theme song. Oh, is it going to have, like, different ones? It's kind of neat. UK wants a lot access. What are you doing? At war with the Netherlands. Really? You're on the side of Belgium? No. Why are you at war with the Belgium? With the Dutch? Because they were taking Gabu. Yeah, you fucking idiots. Orange seems like they're going to get away with theirs somehow, but... Study circle. Sure, whatever. Prestige. No, you don't get access. I don't want that. Unfortunately, I think I'm going to have to call it pretty much now without this giant war happening. I mean, I guess it's a bit of a cliffhanger is the shitty thing. Like, I would have liked to I mean, at least we did get a war in with footage alone, which is easy. These rebels also seem like they're going to be a problem soon. Orange wants another alliance. Yes. The rebels. Oh, that's 7 million militant socialists. Speaking of big things that are about to happen, let's raise the minimum wage so that they just fuck off. Yep, but that is that's something that I think is going to come up later. Like, you can only raise the minimum wage so many times before they just kill you. But yeah. I think I'm just going to have to call it here. And next time we're going to have World War I for real. I mean, we did go to war with the UK, and we fucked them up, and that was nice, and we got some stuff out of it. We got righteous Heligoland back, which is, you know... I mean, you look at this map, and you can immediately see, ah, this Germany player knows what he's doing. He's got Heligoland. And also, you know, nice bit of Africa when we did that. But next time, kill some more labor union people. Next time we'll have to do the real World War I, or World War II if you want to call it that, but it's not, it's World War I. But yeah, that's going to have to do it. I will probably be streaming again tomorrow. And I don't know what, maybe Nier Automata, Pokemon, something new, something, I don't know. If you want to check it out, it's in the Discord, I'll say it. But yeah, that'll have to do it, because it is getting late. Been playing a lot of this game. Yeah, I'll see you. Have a good one. Bye-bye.